Alright, I went to Walmart and it's time for an unboxing video. So I got two of them, two Cosmic Eclipse blister packs. We have the Victini and the Celebi. And we are going to be opening Victini today first, Celebi in another episode. So we'll just like put her background, because why not? And the Victini also is very... Let me get my shadow out of the way. It's very, like, not really glip, but, like, the packs are kind of weird. I don't know if you can tell, but, like, the pack right here, the pack plastic is, like, got sucked underneath. So we're going to crack this sucker open. Recently went to Popeye's to check out their new Popeye's chicken sandwich, see if it's actually all that worth it. And, it actually is. I got to adjust my camera real quick so this might make some weird noises. The Popeye's chicken sandwich is a lot better than I thought it would be, considering that the Popeye's chicken sandwich is, like, considered the best sandwich. I thought it would just be, like, a regular chicken sandwich, and the hype didn't really mean anything. I had to get some slurps of my Sprite. Sadly, they will not be returning Sprite Cranberry during holiday season. We should boycott regular Sprite goods until they return Sprite Cranberry for the holiday season. So let me get like a pocket knife. Let's see. Is my pocket knife that easy? Yes. Pocket knife is easily accessible. Alright. Okay, give me a second while I take this out. Alright, we got the booster packs out, and yeah, you can kind of see where the pack art kind of got warped underneath. These booster packs feel, like, super full of air, which is frustrating, and I do not like that, but that's fine. We got Victini warped, as usual. Actually, I gotta move the Celebi thing back here for a minute. I forgot to get my sleeves on the outside end of that. Mutual agreement. Okay, so here's the code card, except uno digit. Alright, I'll just check this on top of all the regular booster packs. I have a code card stack that I use that I put on my used code cards. I don't know why I do it. I just got some leftover. Where did I put? I don't know where I put the trash. Well, I could just chucked it off to the side. Like I always do. Alright, where do I do? Okay, where did the card? Alright, here's the card. I'm gonna go. Alright. The card is warped. Every single freaking promo card these days is always warped. Frustrating. But, in the end, you can't do anything about it. In order to make the card not warped, you'd have to go to the factory and fix stuff. That's too much work. So, you got Cosmic. I almost shanked myself. Shanked myself real good. Alright. So, we got a... Looks like we got a Palkia, Arceus, and... Not... We got Dialga, Palkia, Arceus artwork. We got Solgaleo and Lunala artwork, and the babies. I don't know. I forgot their names. I'm going to read the back real quick, because I have not read the back. Alright. Supreme Connections of Stars and Pokemon. The Shadow. I'll read it to you guys. The Supreme Connections of Stars and Pokemon. At the apex of the Sun and Moon series, the Pokemon TCG Sun and Moon Cosmic Eclipse expansion boosts the connection of Pokemon and trainers. It launches tag team combinations to a new level, jump into battle with Charizard, breaks into the level, but okay. It's like all backs trying to advertise. Alright, so I have a new concept that I like to introduce with you guys. Each episode, we take one pack and we put it inside the king's eyeball. Yeah, my king with his makeshift crown. And then, like, every 10 unboxing episodes, we open his we open the packs inside of here. So I don't have a good feeling about this booster pack. Slide it into the King's Eyeball. Let's open up these two suckers. Okay. Alright, so how has your guys' day been? I don't have a face cam because I'm testing out a new genre. A new genre of card opening. I don't know if that's technically pleasable, but that's what I'm going to be doing. I also have a new idea of releasing code cards out through the entire episode. How it's going to work is I'll randomly give the code cards out in every episode I make, and I'll give you guys one code card per video. So in this episode, I gave you guys the code card to the thingy. We got Apom. I give you guys the code card to the blister pack itself. I'll give you guys the individual booster pack codes in my gaming episodes, and I might decide to hide one in today's episode, just to be fun. So we got Cricketot and Apom. Here we have Woobat about to woo some ladies. Am I right? Ducklet. Swirlix having a grand old time. We got a green boy. We got Ambipom, evolution of the previous Pokemon. We got Lana's fishing rod. The reverse, nope. We got Vaporeon. We got Teddy Ursa in Gaping. And a holo Blastfeelon. That is cool holo. You deserve one of the crappier versions of the sleeves I have. You get to go make your nest within this plastic case. Where did I put Victini? I don't know where I put Victini. I don't know what I do with life anymore. So we're just going to put this person right there. Put this person right there. Oh, that's what happened to Victini. Totally didn't even see her. I will just put Hollows there. Okay, so that was not a savvy Pokemon pack. I would appreciate it if that Pokemon pack, instead of a holo, was like a Mega Rare or something savvy like that. Do I got a good feeling about this? I do not. In fact, I actually have quite the opposite. I have a mediocre feeling. I don't know if that's pleasable to my endeavors. But that is okay. I don't know why I keep doing that. Usually I just four to the front, but now I'm doing this weird Houdini crap. Onix. Tepig. Alolan Sandshrew. Snorunt. Koffing. Fire energy, because that's fire. We got Delmai sink to the bottom of the ocean. Island Challenge. That is a weird name. I don't appreciate that. We got Curly. Oh! Oh, sick. Anything cool? No, we have a trash ice cream cone. But, oh, that is. Oh, yes. Oh. Oh, yes. That is a savvy card. Let me look at the. Slightly off-centering, favoring the left side. You can see it on the right. It's favoring the right side. In the front. Slight scuffs visible on the side, on the very tips of the card. But other than that, it's a super sick pull. It's also considered, oh my gosh, the glare and stuff is everywhere. Let's see, can I get to focus? Alright, you got this camera, I believe in you. I believe in this camera. At the same time, I don't. Okay, so I'm testing out a GoPro. It's really good, but it's also really bad at showing really small things. So we got a character card Gallade, and the glare is ridiculous, but I need that thing up there to be on so I can actually see stuff. So it's number 244 out of 236. Oh, this looks like my favorite character card. I've seen some others like Mimikyu, and I think Mimikyu is one of the most sought after ones. But personally, I look like this Gallade looks super cool in person. But that's cool. We got two bangers. I wonder what's in that last pack. Well, I did say I got bad feelings from it. So I think I'm going to get bad stuff out of that booster pack. Wait, let me take one last look at this sucker off camera. Yes, it looks quite good. I am very pleased with this. So let's do a really small recap. So let's put our two holographics in front of this so that it looks like a recap. So we got Victini, Fire V. We got we have Flaming V. That chicken sandwich I had later. Oh, that was so good. We also got Blasphalafion. We got a Happy Q-Tip. Then Gallade character card. Pull of the box. I don't know how much it's worth. Probably at max like $3. Might be more. Probably more. All right. So, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Stay tuned to my YouTube channel to see me unbox the Celebi box next. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye. Whoop. That was just pretty crappy. Let me go check it.